The names of Greek and Roman gods of mythology were the names of NASA's first manned missions to space, which set the tradition of linking space missions to mythological figures. So who invents and assigns names to spacecraft? NASA's first mission was called Mercury Project, in honor of the messenger of the gods. Originally, Mercury Project was named Project Astronaut. However, Dwight Eisenhower, the U.S. president at the time, felt that this gave too much prominence to the astronauts, and so the name was changed to Mercury. The capsule was sent into orbit on top of both a Redstone rocket and an Atlas rocket, both originally designed as missiles for the U.S. military. So the project was named Mercury, after a Roman god who was very fast. Although the project was called Mercury, each astronaut could name his particular capsule himself. Alan Shepard named his Mercury capsule Freedom 7, including the number 7 because it was the 7th version of the capsule made, and was also in honor of the original 7 astronauts chosen for the Mercury project. Gus Grissom's capsule was Liberty Bell 7. John Glenn's was Friendship 7. Gordon Cooper's was Faith 7. Wally Schirra's was Sigma 7, and Scott Carpenter's capsule was Aurora 7. Project Gemini, originally the Mercury Mark II program, was NASA's second human spaceflight program. The name Gemini was chosen because of the twin stars Castor and Pollux in the constellation Gemini, which in Latin means twins, symbolizing the program's two-man crew that would carry it into orbit. After Gus Grissom christened his capsule Molly Brown, a reference to his sunken Mercury capsule, NASA adopted a new rule that the Gemini space capsules were allowed to be referred to only by mission numbers. Although Project Gemini was named after the constellation, pronounced Gemini, NASA declared that the official pronunciation of the operation was Gemini. For the Apollo missions, the figure of Apollo on a chariot pulling the sun across the sky corresponds to the scale and ambitions of the Apollo program. Apollo was a significant god to both Greeks and Romans. Beginning with the Apollo 9 mission, two different spacecraft were used for each mission, the lunar module and the command module. The crew for each mission was responsible for naming both the command and lunar modules. Originally, the crew of Apollo 11 named the command module Snowcone and the lunar module Haystack, based on the shapes of the vehicles. NASA felt that these names did not inspire much confidence in the spacecraft or the mission, so the names were changed to Columbia for the command module and Eagle for the lunar module. Names chosen by the crews of the Apollo missions included Apollo 9, Spider and Gumdrop, Apollo 10, Snoopy and Charlie Brown, Apollo 12, Intrepid and Yankee Clipper, Apollo 13, Aquarius and Odyssey, Apollo 14, Antares and Kitty Hawk, Apollo 15, Falcon and Endeavor, Apollo 16, Orion and Casper, Apollo 17, Challenger and America. In 1960, NASA adopted these basic rules for naming spacecraft. The name of the project should be a simple euphonic word. The name should not be duplicated and confused with other NASA projects. The names should reflect the mission of the project when possible, and names can be serialized, but only after a successful flight or achievement. In 1994, NASA launched another new tradition with spacecraft names. The first American Mars rover was named after an open competition among school children and students. After a nationwide contest, open only to school children, a panel made up of 4,700 volunteer judges, educators, professionals, and space enthusiasts reviewed the entries and narrowed the field down to 155 entries. After that, the field was narrowed down to 9 entries. The public then had 5 days to weigh in on their favorites. Those results were then submitted to NASA, who would make the final decision on the name. Many of the rest of NASA's spacecraft, such as Spirit, Opportunity, Curiosity, and Ingenuity, have all been named that way. In 2000, NASA adopted a new policy directive on official names for major NASA projects. The following were the new principles. Project names will be simple and easy to pronounce. Names will not be duplicated or be so similar to other names that they create confusion. Serialized projects will include Arabic numbers. Acronyms are to be avoided in selecting names, except where the acronym is descriptive and easily pronounced. Names will be printed with only the first letter capitalized. NASA also declared that names should be one name only. The space shuttle era set a new naming trend for NASA. The original working title of the first space shuttle was Constitution, because NASA planned to launch the Constitution in 1976 on Constitution Day. However, fans of the TV series Star Trek launched a campaign demanding to name the shuttle Enterprise. A couple of weeks before launch, President Ford vetoed the officially proposed name and stated that he was partial to the name Enterprise, citing that he had served in the Navy aboard the USS Enterprise. Challenger was named after a British research vessel. Discovery was named after explorer Henry Hudson's ship. Atlantis was named after the first American ship for oceanographic research. Endeavour was named after explorer James Cook's exploration ship. And Columbia was named after the Columbia Rediviva, the first boat to circumnavigate the world. Other spacecraft, like MAVEN, exploring Mars' atmosphere, is an acronym, which comes from Mars Atmosphere and Volatile Evolution Spacecraft, MAVEN. The Mariner, Surveyor, and Viking probes were named by NASA after nautical terms, to convey the impression of travel to great distances and remote lands. The Voyager spacecraft were originally called Mariner 1 and Mariner 2, or Mariner Jupiter Saturn, and were originally to explore the planets of our inner solar system. But Mariners are in a different class of spacecraft, designed for flights to the inner planets, so the name was changed to Voyager. NASA named the Orion spacecraft, originally called Crew Exploration Vehicle, after one of the largest constellations in the sky. The Hubble telescope is named in honor of the great American astronomer Edwin P. Hubble, who discovered that the universe is expanding and derived Hubble's law, which describes how rapidly it is expanding. The James Webb telescope is named after a former NASA administrator who led the agency through the glory years of the Apollo missions. The upcoming program to return humans to the moon is called Artemis, because Artemis was the twin sister of Apollo. The New Horizons probe, which studied Pluto, was chosen because it evokes a sense of peering past the edge of the solar system. Even the rockets that carried astronauts to space have borne names of Roman and Greek gods, such as Centaur, Thor, Atlas, and Saturn. NASA has recently departed from its policy by naming a spacecraft after a living scientist. The Parker Solar Probe is named after heliophysicist Eugene Parker. For the future, NASA will give names to spacecraft as it has in the past that are often inspirational, borrowing names from Greco-Roman mythology and ships from the Age of Exploration. For the most part, the names of projects and spacecraft begin either as NASA in-house suggestions in special committees or in NASA-approved research projects, suggestions by astronauts in manned missions, or the rare essay contest. The name is then reviewed by the Deputy Associate Administrator for the Office of Communications. He reviews the recommendation, makes a selection, and then submits the name to the administrator for final approval. But as dramatic and on point as spacecraft names, such as Curiosity, may be, NASA is still a government institution and is governed by bureaucratic rules relating to every detail of every space-going mission.